Bible with me, I'm Jack, and we are with
RB and Jamal.
Rico the Great.
Two artists from Chicago, visual painting artists. Questions.
Let's go.
That need answers.
Let's go.
First of all, where y'all from is that?
We grew up out in the south suburbs. We went to high school together. South suburbs, the 100s, you know, from 82nd today to Richard Park. South Pole side, a little bit everywhere.
So y'all been friends for a while?
Freshman year.
They're like love buddies, guys. They're like love buddies.
I don't know about
17
that.
17 years.
Yeah. Tell us about your journey, how you guys got started with painting and the visual arts.
Man, as far as art, man, we all been at Mr. Norton, Mr. Baird's class.
Rest in peace, he just died.
Yeah, our teacher who basically kicked all our art careers off and us being creative. So we was in there and he just basically was like, said that we, including some of our classmates and some of the dopest artists he's ever had, and just gave us his credit card one day and told us to go online and buy whatever art supplies he wanted.
Really?
And we basically brought all type of crazy stuff. So I started painting. He started going crazy with the illustration of the markers and stuff like that. Then he exposed us to art schools. He took us to Columbia Art Institute, different places like that. So he ended up going to the Art Institute, Columbia. And I ended up going to Southern. My parents had wanted to go to art school, so I went to Southern and I majored in art. So I switched the script. So basically, we ended up graduating. We both got our degrees in art. Came back, he was doing a graphic design thing, we started working on graphic design, web design, and we had a conversation at Red Lobster.
And that shit, those butter biscuits?
Yeah, it's cheddar biscuits.
Those cheddar biscuits.
That's the conversation that kind of like kicked us.
They kicked the money move.
Exactly.
Like, what's the money move?
Well, look, I feel like this, I've been doing art since I was a shorty. My mother's a talented artist. She can look at something and draw.
Really?
So yeah, she's been an educator her whole life. She's an assistant superintendent now. Been a principal for 15 years, teaching since I was born. I would help her doing her stuff for her classroom when she was third grade, fourth grade teacher and stuff. So like, then I took that and just started doing it in school. Just drawing Ninja Turtles and stuff. And people were like, "Oh, this is dope." And I had a teacher named Mr. Barron and Neil Armstrong in the South Suburbs. He was like, "Yo, you're actually really good. Like, you're way beyond your years at drawing." And but I just did art. I kept doing it. And I started smoking weed, experimenting with drugs, and things. And then the shit got crazy. I never really thought about it like that. But Mr. Mayor, rest in peace again. Like you said, this dude just literally was like, "Yo, y'all were wasting y'all talent. We were just bad kids." Like, I mean, he wasn't as mad as I was. I was fucking terrible.
Shoot dice in class. I was like, great. Like,
he was like, "Y'all could be doing so much." This dude, he was rich. So like, he was coming to, not the hood, but I mean, from where he's from, this is hood shit. Urban. He didn't have to come to this school. He didn't have to do this job. Never had to work. He loved, like, helping, putting that spark in somebody's head. Yeah, it all started from him though, where it kind of took off. But the Red Lobster story without passing him is where we started realizing that, quit your job.
So basically, I was following from what I do on Instagram, and I was like, man, he was an art club.
Okay.
So I told him, we were sitting in Red Lobster one day, we both were teaching at the time. He was at Rich Central, I was at elementary school teaching. And we both, we got off work, we went to get something to eat and some drinks. We're like, man, we're tired of this shit, man. Kids are cool, but fuck this shit. We love kids, but fuck the curriculum and all the other bullshit that we got to deal with. So I was like, "Hey man, you should reach out to this dude." And I was like, "Man, he's a collector." I was like, "Your style fits with the type of stuff he buys." So he ended up hitting him up, and then about two weeks later, he ended up contacting him and told him like, "Hey,
Well, I almost fucked it up. I almost jagged this dude. I ain't gonna put his name on here. We ain't beefing, but he put me in the game. I don't want to give him no credibility right now. But no, he kicked some stuff off and it was dope. He basically showed me he showed me people he's been collecting and told me the way to go.
Right.
He literally told me to do one thing. He was like, "You're dope. I like your style. I give you basically 6 days to do a pizza. It was my birthday. I was going to Dallas to drink heavily. Nothing that involved
nothing.
I cut my shit short and literally come back and bust my ass because I knew his opportunity and how he talked to me and what he collects. The dude has Picasso in his house. And he kicked off stuff when he rent. Like he had originals and stuff and some great conversations for another interview from him that I can bring out about that. But I did the pieces for him. He wanted to buy 4 other pieces from me. Dropped it off to him on a Molly drug deal, which is awesome. It's some weird, story.
I love shit like that.
It was my boy birthday. I won't put his name out there because he's I don't want to mess him up. But I literally was dropping the stuff off to get paid, but I had to meet this other girl to pick up Molly from downtown. So I dropped off, which is weird. It's like I had never seen him. He doesn't post pictures of his face. Like,
it's everything, art, it's all art,
watches and
cars.
Really? He's like one of those guys that follow this, like SP Jewelers, as like all like the, like, they don't show their faces,
but
they don't
know who the fuck they are. These little stick up boys will kill them. They live in Chicago, so easily anybody can get you, and it makes sense. And he talks about that too.
Yeah.
Like his Instagram is amazing, it's cool, but.
Chicago, we have to love each other in that game. You know what I'm saying? Okay.
So long story short, he kicked off the whole thing. And I'd always been telling him, like, dude, you need to paint, you need to paint, you need to paint. He always said, man, you need to show me how to paint. I'm like, man, I can't show you how to paint, man. You just need to do this shit. And he just started doing shit one day. And then Sprague, I was drunk as hell at IFES, talking to Hebrew Brady. And I showed Hebrew this dude's work. And I said, man, he colored me. I'm fucked up. And I said, man, my boy colored me. And he looked at his shit and said, he's cold. He's like, well, that's the thing. And I called him and said, hey, you need to start painting. And he started painting. And we just moved forward from that.
So that question that he posed, do you actually paint? What is, I'm confused. Like,
Originally all I used to do, I painted too, I should say that, but I never was like buying canvases. Like I would mix media and stuff. So I'll put some paint on like a piece of paper when I'm doing a marker or ballpoint pen. And I don't do pencil, I hate pencil, I think it's the worst thing in the world. If I mess up something, I get to fix it. I have to figure a way out. It's like a man.
Yeah.
It's like my, I'm trying to stop the curse. If I mess up, if I fuck some shit up, I gotta figure my way out of it. So when I had my clients in Prism Color, which you probably don't know, it's just type of ink and a type of marker. If I fuck something up, I cut out one accident, some lid or some eyes, some shit like that. I have to figure out how to make this shit work. But sometimes I take it, I mean, I'm not really religious, so I hate when I just say I take it from a sign from God, like this is what I was supposed to
do. Yeah, it's like
but I take it from something, like it's like shit, this line just holds something up. And like when I draw, it's crazy because people look at me like I'm fucking stupid. When I'm at the airport, some people just look at me and just blow them away. When I look at a piece of paper, I start with like 4 or 5 different lines, and then fucking I see these little fucking like lines, light lines, and that's showing me where the fuck.
Okay.
So it's like, am I really doing this shit or is this shit like on my day home? It's like, I don't know who the fuck knows, but like I see that shit and it just makes my stuff dope. So when he says like me coming to painting, I literally just used to draw. So my painting style, like it's 2 pieces. It's completely different than my digital illustration or my anything I put